Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Deep Understanding of Research Papers. Today in this tutorial I will explain the paper Unspeech, Unsupervised Speech Context Embeddings by Benjamin Milday and Chris Bayman. So the tutorial is going to cover the overview of the paper, then we will see what is the proposed models for generating these unsupervised speech embeddings. Then we will see what is the data set used for generating these embeddings, and then we will see some experiments and results. So the overview of the paper is the Unspeech algorithm is designed to generate context embeddings using speech data, and this is done using purely unsupervised way, which means we don't need any text or speaker or language information to generate these context embeddings. So we can simply take speech data, let's say English speech data, and then generate unsupervised speech embeddings or context embeddings using this unsupervised speech data. And in this paper they generate the embeddings using up to 9500 hours of crawled English speech data, which is from TED Talk from YouTube. Then we don't use any speaker or transcription information for this for generating these embeddings. Then the training is done using the learning objective based on context and non-context discrimination, and this is done along using something called negative sampling, which is very well known algorithm, which is being used in WorldTwec as an NCE criteria. If you read a 2012 WorldTwec paper by Thomas Mikuloff, they have used this trick to generate the word embeddings. And what we observe is these unspeech embeddings or context embeddings can be used to evaluate speaker comparison and utterance clustering, and then you can also use these embeddings for speech recognition. And this paper also shows that using these speech embeddings gives better performance of speech recognition compared to I vector baselines on TiddlyM dataset. And one more important thing is they have released the code and pre-trained model online. So the proposed model, is nothing but an unsupervised, or an algorithm is basically an unsupervised way of generating speech context embeddings. And for this, what we do is we create this problem with a binary classification task, where we take two speech segments and we compare them. If the two speech segments are in context, then we have to classify that as one, which is nothing but probability of one. Or if they are not same, means if the two speech segments are not next to each other or they are not in a context, then we will make it zero. And the input, I mean, when I say the speech input, is nothing but the filter bank input. And also, if you say one target window, which is nothing but one speech segment, can have multiple context windows. For example, let's say we are in the middle of a speech and we can look at the left or right context, or we can look at two left and two right context, or three left and three right context. So we can form a pair of a target and a context segments, which is nothing but context segments of filter bank images. And we can, if they are in the same sense, if the target and context are in context in the speech, then we will make it classified as one. If they are randomly sampled from the data or speech data, then we will classify it as zero. So for example, if you look at target window, we can denote the embeddings generated by that target window as embed T, EMT, as I denote here. And if you take another speech segment, we can classify that embedding as EMBC, which is nothing but the context embedding, which is also a true embedding, which can be true embedding or it can be negative sample. So the whole whatever I explained like in the previous slide is going to look like this. You will get a clarity. For example, you have a target in the middle here. Look at this speech segment, which is of 0.5 second. This speech segment has been converted into a spectrogram or filter bank matrix. And this filter bank matrix as the target here, which is of 0.5 second. Then you have a context and a left context and a right context. And you also have a left context and right context, right? Now we are going to form a pair like this. We take the target, which is the middle, then we have four different contexts here, like 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can form a pair of the target and the context, so we get four pairs, and we want to classify these pairs as one because they are in context. Then we also sample random context. For example, we sample this and we sample some other context or some other segment from some other sentence, that becomes a negative sample. So that way we create four different negative samples. So each one is not same, or they are not even context, they are not even in same context. So we have to classify these pairs as zeros, right? So that is the whole idea. So whatever I explained in the previous slide, is you can understand with this slide. Then that is the whole idea of generating embeddings. You can ask like, how are we going to get the embeddings and all, we'll answer that. So before that, so this is what we want to do. We want to take this target and we want to find the context. If they are same, if they are in context, we want to make the model learn one. If it is not, then we want to make it zero. So how are we going to do is, the object we are trying to optimize is a binary cross entropy. We want to predict either 0 or 1. So this C is nothing but the output, which should be between, it should be 0 or 1. So the loss, which is going to take input as X, is nothing but the binary cross entropy equation, which you guys know by this equation, right? And you can ask, what is this X, right? This X is actually a number which you are going to generate once you multiply the embedding of the target, the transposed embedding of the target, with the context embedding. Now the thing is, if this true embedding or target embedding and this context embedding are actually the context and the target, then this X should be able to, this X should be able to contribute to this number, because we want to maximize this number. That means we want to make this C to be 1, right? So that is the idea. So this is nothing but the dot product of the target embedding and the context embedding. So we want to maximize that output. So maximizing that output, which is maximize the probability, is nothing but minimizing the cross entropy. So that's why we have the loss. We want to minimize this loss, right? And if my inputs means the target and the context are randomly sampled from the data, we are going to get these embeddings, which are embed negative I and transpose and embed negative 2 transpose. These are randomly sampled negative samples from the data set. These whatever number we get after we take the dot product of these, which is x, should make the probability or C, the value C should be equal to 0, right? And more importantly, we are not going to take only one negative sample, we are going to take k negative samples. So that's why we can take this loss as this, like minus k into log of embed t, and this we want to maximize, or we want to get whenever we see the true target and the context, we want to get capital C equal to 1. If we don't see, or if we don't if the target and context are not in the context, I mean they are not next to each other, if they are randomly sampled, then we should be able to make this number, which is C equal to 0. So if you say sample k samples, then we are going to use sum, right? So this is a very well known equation in CE. So how is the model architecture look? So model architecture is like this. We have same as network here. So same as network, everybody knows that it has two networks, but it's not two network, it's one network but shared parameters. So one, you can think of it as two network, but each one, both of them are shared weights. So look at this, this is one, let's say left network, and this is the, let's say right network. We are going to pass, whenever we pass the target window and the context window. So here the target window is 64x40. You can think of this 64 as the x-axis, which is the time axis, the 64 features and 64 frames, and 40 is the y-axis, which is the number of features in each frame, right? And we have a target window on the left and context window on the right. So when we pass this image, a small image, to a VGG network, so basically the network we are using is a convolution network, which is the VGG 16, and the output of that network is a one-dimensional embedding, or it's a sort of you can think of as sort of hidden layer output from the last layer, right? So that embedding has a size n, and then the context window also goes through the another right network, which is again VGG network, and you are going to get another embedding which is of size n. Now we will take the dot product of these two embeddings scaled by alpha, both the embeddings are scaled by alpha. Then we have to decide if we have to make the network value, the binary value c equal to 1 if we get target and context window, or target and context segments. But if we get negative 1 and negative 2 segments, then we should make this equal to 0, right? This is sort of logistic logistic regression where you predict 0 or 1, right? Now, as you know, the input to the model, the CMS network, is going to be filter bank features, filter bank matrix, filter bank features, which is taken over 0.5 second, let's say. It's going to be one small image. Then, as you know, that filter bank image gets projected into a small embedding, which is of dimension n. And for that projection, we are using this VGG-based, VGG16 style convolutional neural network. And as you know, this VGG network is being used as a CMS network, where we share the weights of this network as a CMS network. In the CMS network, we process two different inputs. Then also they say that they are using dropouts with L2 regularization of this much, and they use Adam for optimization. So coming to the data set they have used in this paper, they have used Tidlium version 2 data, which is almost 211 hours of training and 2 hours of testing and 1 hour of dev and 1 hour of testing. And speakers, again, is here like 1200 plus speakers for train and 14 for dev and test 13. And they also are using this Common Voice version 1 data, which was released like around last year. And they have 242 hours of evaluated data, I mean the corrected data, and 5 hours of dev and 5 hours of test, and these many sentences or speakers are available. Then this is not enough, because we are training a unsupervised model, and we want to give as much as data possible, because we can get a lot of data online, like for example YouTube or any other source, you can name it. And for this particular approach, or for this particular model, they have used TEDx data by crawling YouTube videos from TEDx website, and by doing that they get 9,505 hours of data, which is huge, and they have around 41,000 speakers or 41,000 talks. Basically there may be repetitive speakers. So this is the data they have used for training the Unspeech model, which is good, because for unsupervised, this is unsupervised training, you don't have to annotate the data, you don't have to say what is being spoken in the speech or who is speaking this data. And that is the data set. And using this data set, they have, once they train the unspeech model, they have conducted 4 different experiments here. So one is to figure out same or different speaker experiment. So same different speaker experiment is sort of given to speech signal. You have to tell whether these two speeches are spoken by the same speaker or not, right? That's speech, same or different speaker experiment. Then have clustering utterance. So basically they want to cluster similar experience, similar utterances. Then they have acoustic model with unspeech cluster ID, and then finally they have unspeech context vector for TDN and HMM model. So basically the interesting ones are the 1 and 4, where first one is to find out given two utterances are the same, a sort of speaker speaker you can say verification, right? Somewhat similar but not exactly. That is one thing. The last one is also interesting. It's about how do you increase the performance of the speech recognition model given this unspeech context vectors, right? And we will see only the first and last experiment, and if you're interested, you can look at the second and third experiment in the paper. So first one is you want to classify your two speech signals which can be from same speaker or from a different speaker. And if they are same speaker, you want to classify them as same. I mean, you have to classify them as same speaker. If they are different, you have to classify them as different speaker. And by doing this, you can calculate the equal error rate. And the experiment is done with TiddlyM version 2 data. And each embedding, the n dimension, which we saw in the previous diagram, has the dimension 100 in all experiment. And you can train the models for different target window, basically width, for example, 32, 64, 128. And the results are like this. So basically you have I vector baseline, then we have unspeech 32 context window, target window size and target window width, for example. Then we have 64 TEDx, and this TEDx is basically that full test data. And you can see that the model training, actually the best model is basically I vector only, right? So these models are not beating the I vector baseline. And finally we have this unspeech context vector used for TDN and HMM. Basically TDN and HMM is a speech recognition model, a time delay neural network combined with the hidden Markov model, and the model is trained using TiddlyM data set. And as you can see here, we have here is the context vector. The context vector could be nothing. I mean, no context vector. You have a E vector, context vector. You have unspeech with the different context widths, target widths. And here we have the dev error rate and test error rate. And this is plain, basically is no rescoring. And rescoring is basically language model rescoring. One more time. And we can see that for dev, I vector is performing well, and for test, actually we are getting this unspeech 64 is performing a little bit better, right? This is for TiddlyM data, and they have done the same experiment with Common Voice data also. So Common Voice is basically Mozilla's open source speech data for English, and they show that for Common Voice data, I vector, the unspeech embeddings combined with the TDN and HMM as a context vectors actually outperforms all the other models with dev and test WERs. And plain is again no rescoring, and rescoring is window rescoring. And thank you so much for watching this video. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe for more content. And thank you.